Hey, Daniel here to talk about the three best ways to detect tempo in Cubase. The scenario I am often faced with is working with an artist who brings a beat where the tempo is fixed but has no metadata on the beats per minute. This isn't ideal if you plan to use effects that sync to the project tempo, like delay. I've imported one of my instrumentals as an example with no metadata and will showcase three ways to figure out the tempo. Let's play the audio with the click on and the project tempo set to 120 BPM by default. Clearly obvious that 120 is not the tempo of this track. Now, most tracks have a brief moment of silence before the music starts, and to capture the tempo accurately, you want the audio event to start on the first downbeat of the song. Now, you can either manually click from the bottom of the event and drag to the start, or if you've seen my previous video, you can use the cut to first hit point macro, which I've assigned to Control H. The link to view the video will be in the description. So now I can drag it to the first bar. The first way is using the tempo detection tool, which is available only in the pro version of Cubase. So we can select that by going to Project, Tempo Detection, and select Analyze. Now, by default, it will always add a signature track and set it to one beat per bar. So I click on the signature track and double click to select it to 4. So the track is actually 80 beats per minute, but it's hovering between 161, I'm seeing 144, 152, 153. What we can do as a tempo adjustment function is divide by 2. So now suddenly we're getting closer to the right tempo. We're seeing 80, 81, 82. And if I play it back, it hasn't gotten the beat position right. So I can also select the offbeat correction. So from the top, we can see it's also still detecting 70 here, but thinks it's 81 here. At this point, I would set the tempo back to fixed mode, manually set it to 80. I'll also close the panel, return to using the selection tool, and just check at various points. So this is how I would use the tempo detection tool to get an approximate tempo and then use that to test at various points in the audio to ensure that that is accurate. The second way is using the tap tempo function added in Cubase 13 as a replacement for the beat calculator. So if I click on the tap tempo mode icon, it's set to set project tempo. So if I turn the click off, then let the beat play, and while holding shift, press enter to the beat of the song. So once I stop, after a few seconds, it will set the project tempo, and you can see visually whether it lines up on the percussive elements. So it set it to 79.75. So I would approximate up to 80 at this point, which I know is correct. So using the tap tempo is arguably less accurate depending on how good your timing is. The third way is using the set tempo from event tool. So we want to move the cursor to the end of the fourth bar from the start of the instrumental, counting 4 bars for better accuracy. You can also rely on visual cues depending on the percussive elements of the song. So I know that I can stop it around here for this particular track. I'll zoom out. We want to cut the audio event using Alt or Opt and X. And we now want to drag the left and right locators to the first 4 bars of the project, representing the actual number of bars we've estimated for this particular event. So I'll select the event, go to Audio, Advanced, Set Tempo from Event. And what that now does is adjust the project tempo based on the audio event being set within the locators. which gives it an approximate reading of 80.209, which can ultimately be rounded down to 80. So I can zoom out a little more, just delete that event and just drag this one to the end and set the project tempo to 80. Using the set tempo from event tool can be more accurate than relying on the tap tempo function or using the tempo detection tool, but it is slightly more involved. But regardless of what method you use, you want to set the tempo to the audio file. And you can set the audio file tempo within the lower window toolbar. With the event highlighted, you can just set the defined tempo to 80 in this case. If you don't see this within your toolbar, just right click on the empty space and make sure that the musical information box is ticked. Now, with that ticked, we can just click this again and enable musical mode, which will allow us to change the tempo to anything we want with everything still synced correctly. Which method did you prefer? Let me know in the comments below. Like and share if this has been helpful. Take care.